The humble New York City Parsons Art School project, started by Shawnee Salt and Rob Zombie, would go on to be one of metal's biggest names in the mid-90s. With the 25th anniversary of their landmark and final recording, Astro-Creep 2000, Songs of Love, Destruction, and Other Synthetic Delusions of the Electric Head, we're looking into what made this an essential part of history. This is Frank from Metal Injection with 25 facts you may not know about White Zombie's Astro-Creep 2000. Michael Olago, the young New York City-based A&R executive who signed acts like Metallica to Elektra Records, is also responsible for giving White Zombie their big label break when signing them to Geffen Records in the early 90s. After critical and commercial success with Los Exorcisto, the band was firing on all cylinders to create and promote what would be their final full-length together. Despite Los Exorcisto being the band's debut on a major label, it wasn't until the creation of Astro-Creep that they saw a real budget. Jay has gone on record to credit having more money and time as the biggest factor to why Astro-Creep sounds so different than all their previous recordings. With the band members slowly drifting apart after the romantic breakup of lead vocalist Rob Zombie and bassist Shawnee Salt, Zombie personally worked towards making the music a more industrial effort, making the guitars and bass to be written over electronic rhythms instead of starting with them. With former drummer Ivan Deprume stepping down to start his own studio, the band quickly hired John Tempesta, known for his work with Exodus and Testament at the time. Tempesta would later follow Rob Zombie in his solo career following the band's breakup. Drummer John Tempesta is the brother of Mike Tempesta, who you may know as M33, the guitar player for Power Man 5000 in the late 90s, early 2000s. Power Man 5000 is of course led by vocalist Spider-One, who also happens to be the brother of Rob Zombie. With Rob Zombie working the band towards a more electronic sound, he hired Charlie Clouser on board to create the samples and loops found all over the album. Clouser was well known for his keyboard, producing, and programming skills featured in bands like Nine Inch Nails, Marilyn Manson, Typo Negative, Rammstein, and many more. Formerly, the band would record their parts in the same room, opting for a more live recording setting. But Astro-Creep would mark the first time the band chose to record separately, between two different studios. Guitarist Jay has explained in an interview that Astro-Creep was made up of 48 analog and 24 digital tracks. He recalls working on his guitar parts in one studio, while the samples were being worked in another, and tapes were going back and forth all the time. In the end, it took close to 6 weeks to complete the production, which was a very different experience for the band members. Jay has stated during the production of the record that he and Rob had some different opinions on the prominence of the digital elements, and had to fight to keep the band as a dominant sound. Quoting, "Rob was so in love with the loops and samples that he just wanted to erase the band, and so I had to be there all the time to make sure that the band was loud, you know?" With much of Los Exorcisto in the standard E tuning, the band started to mess with the idea of down-tuning half a step during the tour of that album. They took it a step further when writing Astro-Creep 2000, down-tuning 1.5 steps, and wound up recording half the album in C-sharp standard and half in C-sharp drop tuning. As Jay puts it, it's amazing what that relatively minor change does to expand the width and breadth of a band's sound. The music video for the debut single on the album was one of the first completely directed by Rob alone. It features old home video footage of him and his brother, along with his cousins, at an early age, and partially filmed in a Massachusetts high school, the home state they grew up in. After winning an MTV Music Video Award, Zombie admitted it was his favorite White Zombie video. The moaning found on the intro to More Human Than Human was sampled from a post-apocalyptic porn titled Cafe Flesh, which features lead actress Michelle Bauer, who became a prolific B-movie actress of the 80s. Easily the band's most recognizable hit, the song continues to be featured in several video games and films, such as The Cable Guy, Can't Hardly Wait, The Long Kiss Goodnight, True Blood, Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, and many more. Slowly but surely, the band went on to release 3 music videos in promotion for the album, and had plans to begin filming one for Blood, Milk, and Sky, but the plans would never see fruition due to the band's breakup. The album begins with a very memorable line,
"Perhaps you had better start from the beginning."
Taken from the 1957 horror classic, The Curse of Frankenstein, before ripping into the music of the opening track. Although Astro-Creep 2000 was the final album for the band, it wasn't the last original music created by White Zombie. Their final original work included soundtrack selections from the films Escape from L.A., The Crow City of Angels, and Beavis and Butthead Do America. At the 2016 Riot Fest, Rob Zombie decided to celebrate the occasion by performing Astro-Creep 2000 in its entirety. However, he did this with the Rob Zombie Live Band and didn't ask the original members to take part. When pressed about a reunion by fans, he simply stated, "I have many legit reasons for not wanting to reform White Zombie. Just because you don't know them does not mean that they don't exist." Although the band ultimately broke up in 1998, during a Headbangers Ball interview in 1996, Rob Zombie had already hinted that the band experienced tension due to their constant work cycle over the years.
We've basically been on tour for 4 years out of the last 5 years, so we pretty much have had it with each other.
Unfortunately, it seems as though bassist Shawnee Salt and Rob Zombie's relationship has gone sour since the years of White Zombie. She claims in a 2011 interview that he did the lead singer thing and broke off contact with her, along with the other members of White Zombie. The rest of the band remained friends, however.
Would you say movies are your first love or music?
Movies. Always movies.
Yeah?
I like music too, but
second.
But once receiving recognition for his music video work during Astro-Creep 2000, he began to speak about his future in directing film. After disbanding White Zombie and releasing his solo debut, Rob Zombie went on to put his words to action when he began writing and directing his film debut, House of a Thousand Corpses. Since then, he's seen a lot of success in film with other notable cinema releases such as The Devil's Rejects, Three from Hell, Halloween, The Lords of Salem, and many more. In 2010, bassist and co-founder Shawnee Salt released a coffee table book detailing her career in White Zombie and showcasing photos, stories, and clippings from her personal collection. Since White Zombie, Shawnee Salt has relocated to New Orleans and settled down as a fabric designer and acclaimed photographer with gallery exhibits in major cities. She continues to play bass, currently for the band Star and Dagger. Much like Rob and Sean, Jay went on to pursue his ventures including audio production and engineering, and includes mastering credits from Star and Dagger, Sean's band. You can also find him on Instagram as he travels and pursues his passion for photography. The album is easily White Zombie's best-selling record, receiving double platinum certification with over 2.6 million copies sold in the US alone. There is no wonder why this album continues to be celebrated as one of the best 90s metal has to offer, and the reason we're still listening 25 years later. And that's our list. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more updates.